so we're continuing to design the commission member. This is included in the first exam. So the first exam will be district member and commission members. First exam will be district member and commission members. So the first one, last time or last lecture, was introduction. Introduction to commission member. We talked about what's the endowment, what's the latest generation, what's spoiler, mainly what's spoiler button, and how the effect of the endowment. Our house in Dallas affect the strength of a typical car. And usually when the stendamus is high, L over R is high, the member will, but in the elastic range, and stresses in the member will be way below the yield stress, And if the member yield stress of Y is 50 KSI, buckling will occur maybe at 15, 20, 25. This is elastic. Cares when the stendamus is so high, when L over R is so big. Okay? When L over R is so small, it means the column is stocky or short. Short column. Usually, stendamus doesn't have any effect. The member will fail due to the failure of the material, which is the area times of Y. The gross times of R times a strength reduction factor. In between, and you don't have a member that's way have high stendamus ratio or very small stendamus ratio. Most of the columns they are called intermediate columns. L over R is between a range. It's called intermediate columns. And usually there's some plasticity. We use empirical formulas to calculate. The strength. Not pure Euler. Something modified from Euler. Because we said, and this is a very important concept. If someone is telling you, calculate this one and you use Euler, you have to ask him, is it elastic range or not elastic range? If it's not elastic range, you cannot use Euler. Euler is used in elastic range only. Good? So we talked about when you find the commission members, plus members, arch, usually if you have an arch, it's a commission member. There's two structural elements. Two types of structural elements. They are opposite to each other, X bar. Arch and what's the opposite of arch? Cable. Yes. Chapter 4 or 5 in structural analysis called arches and cables, right? Cable is as a tension member only. Doesn't take any compression. And a rope, it's like a rope. No compression, cannot take any compression. Its capacity in compression is zero. That's a cable. Its capacity in tension is so high. يعني الحبل بيجرب لك باسل. It can carry a huge load in tension but cannot develop any compression load. Arch is the opposite. Yeah. Arch member is made the dominant force, the main force of power of the arches in the arches is compression. Okay? So usually arches with some small bending. And small shear. But most of the force is compression. Force. You know the arch? An arch is like a beam. What is the force in the beam? The internal force in the beam. Shear and bending. Right? This is the beam, right? It's a member loaded perpendicular to its major axis. Horizontal member. You start arching it. And you start making it arch. You are changing the shear and moment into axial. That's called the arch action. And you are changing the shear and moment, which is dangerous, into axial. Good? That's why it's used in the ancient Udana. They used to have, to use the arch. Why they want to use the arch? Yeah, in ancient arches are built of what? In Ish'aminu? Stones. Stones are brittle materials. Stone's compressive strength is high, tensile strength is small. 1 over 15 from its compression. يعني 1 على 15 tensile strength من قوة. It's like a concrete. So they changed, found, and discovered the concept of arch such that those stones can take the load. Arch and domes. They are the main force in them are is compression. So the best member to use in arch is your concrete, cheap. But steel, we know, steel, we study is good in compression and tension. As long as stendamus is, or buckling is, secure. buckling, we care about the weak axis. If the weak axis is braced against buckling, then you are forcing the buckling to go above strong axis. It will require higher load. Okay? Weak axis is RY. The Y axis, buckling while the Y axis is easier. Strong axis is the X axis. When I say strong axis, what does it mean? شو معنى strong axis? We said load. Wait. This code, the members are aligned. Members, you're giving dimensions. The members are giving them, right? In this manual, yeah, he's giving you the dimension of one member, right? He's giving you IXX, IYY, RXX, RYY, all of this, right? Those are based on something called X-axis, strong axis and weak axis. The strong axis there is the X-axis. The strong axis, the weak axis is the Y-axis. What does it mean? يعني شنو يعني strong axis? يعني هسه what's the strong axis for this section here? The number. This one. Not this one. This is the weak axis. This is the strong axis. So what does it mean? Strong axis give you a higher moment of inertia. And IXX is higher than IYY. So RXX is bigger than RYY. Of course, because R equals square root of I over A. And A is the same for both. Here is the same. So if IXX is bigger than IYY, it means RXX is bigger than RYY. Square root of I over A. So if I load it, see, it will buckle, right? It will buckle. So it buckled about the weak axis. This axis, about this, means there is bending about this axis. This is the Y, this is the X, this is the weak axis. The weak axis, name it SAT, name it anything, but you know it's about the weak axis. Okay? Bending about it. Bending about it. So this is the inertia in that direction. Good? So the strong axis is this axis. Yes, so that bending is this way. Weak axis is such that bending is about it this way. Easy to bend it, easy to bend it. Because I is small. I is resistant to bending. That's the inertia. How much is it? How much difference do you have? Okay, thank you. So either flexural buckling, you know. Pull. Or. Good. Or local buckling. Still as one piece, but some component, either the flange or the whip or a small component, one leg, if it's an angle, buckle. Just one piece, it's called local buckling. Okay. If it's like I shape or W shape, it's made of flange and whip. So you may have the whip by itself, because this is the axial load. It's supported by the full section. There's a flange, flange and whip, right? Or if there's a T, there's a flange and whip or half. So sometimes the whip could be slender, long compared to its thickness. So it may buckle. Or the flange. There's something called torsional buckling. It may occur in columns that have certain cross-sectional configuration. This occurs in non-symmetric sections. Like see, teach another. T section is non-symmetric section, right? By the way, it's a more axis symmetric. Symmetric about one axis only. Axisymmetric section like T angle or a C. T angle or a C. There is formulas to calculate this one. For each section, we will study what's the governing limit state, what's the equation. Now you understand when I say limit state, right? For any member, either in concrete or in bridges or in steel, in structural design. In structural design, there is strength for each member. We call them limit state strength. Each limit state deals with a failure mode. If the failure is global or flexural buckling, what's the strength? That's a limit state. What's the limit state for against flexural buckling? What's the strength that the member can develop if the failure is flexural buckling? Like if it was yielding of the tension member. Second limit state, fracture of the tension member under the strength. Then block shear. Okay? What if there's local buckling? Local buckling should be avoided. And we can calculate the strength of the member if local buckling to occur. But in any design from now on, which is from like 5 or 10 years, you cannot select any section that with local buckling as an issue. ما بنسمحش فيها. For a new design. You may have existing sections that they have a problem. There's equations and formulas to calculate the strength if there is a problem with the local buffering. But from now on, you cannot use any section as a column if local buffering is an issue. And how do you know it's an issue? It's listed in the manual, or you check the length over the width should be within certain limits. Good? This one also, again, for some members, this may control. We can calculate the strength based on this one. Again, and the manual will help us in this. So this one, this one may not only like buckle globally, it may twist. Usually this doesn't occur by itself. And it's a combination. It can be lateral torsion. Before it buckle, then it will twist. It buckle and twist. It's called lateral torsion. Lateral torsion. Combine both. We cover this, slenderness. Someone said, as I said, if you have any question, we cover all of this information. We talked about the day, what's a day. We talked about residual stresses. We talked about these sections, our structure. And we talked about the effect of slenderness. As slenderness increase, the strength increase, slenderness increase, strength increase. And remember, as we increase the length of the member, its strength goes down in compression. Strength goes down in compression. Okay. Here, there is something here. Okay, there is short columns, there is columns, something called intermediate, L over R. This is L over R, is the slenderness ratio. There is short columns when L over R is very small, very small. It's called short column. It means the column will develop its full capacity, full strength in terms of material. Area times Fy times safety factor, P factor for compression, which is 0.9. You will see it. And there's something called long slender column. L over R is so huge. This one, okay, it's pure elastic. To calculate the strength of the member, when you have this case, L over R is huge, like the roller I showed you, the mustara. Okay? Usually apply Euler exactly. I square E A over K L over R square. Right? Or I square E I over K L square. Remember, the other day, I had a mistake in the beginning. So E critical equal. I square E A over K L over R square. Or y square ei over kl square. Okay? So the critical stress will be p critical over a. It will be y square e over kl over r square. Okay? So most of the columns are here. Most of the columns are here. For this case here, what do we use? Empirical formulas. We cannot use Euler. And it's not 0.9 a gross of 1. It's not. It will be in between. Okay, so there is empirical formulas. Developed based on awaruha bilan ala, developed based on experimental testing. Experimental testing over years. Every 5 years, 10 years, we have new data. People do testing and they say, okay, we revise the code equation. For this case, it doesn't apply. How about modifying this case? There is a committee, Fidejne. They meet every year usually and they say, okay, there's a new data from this researcher, and there is the same data from this researcher, they support this thing, how about we modify this to be that and that? This is how they calibrate the code, based on reputable data, and not any data. You have to have, like, you know, this guy is in the field, Al-Shakhs Mu'tabar, and the study was, I mean, funded properly, it's a reputable study, and you need time, and you need more data, you need to add more data so that you can develop a trend, there is a trend. Elastic, say pure elastic, when you remove the axial loading, it goes back to its original shape. It goes back to its original shape. Elastic or elastic behavior, when you remove the load, there will be permanent deformation. The only recovered part is the plastic portion. Plastic portion. This يعني مش محسوبين على الديفورم شيب اوف ذا ممبر. If you calculate the moments on the deformed shape and there is an axial load, this axial load, what does it cause in here? E delta effect. E delta, there is an additional moment due to the axial times this deflection here. This is called second order analysis. Second order analysis will come, there is additional moment due to the deflection of the member. Not only that, if you have a huge building that will sway left and right, there is a delta for each floor, right? And the gravity loads are down. So that's called floor magnification. There is B small delta for the deflection of the members, and there is B big delta, which is the floor sway. We will cover this one when we talk about the beam column section. You will see. You will learn this really well. So if you apply this one, if the load that you apply is this time the critical buckling, remove it, last time. It's like this one, it's stable. This is stable, no problem. Stable. It's like you have a ball and then corner on this shape. On this shape. If you move it, it's like you are deflecting the beam, the column. If you move it, remove the load, it will go back to its original shape. Remember this? Fine. Stable. It's called stable equilibrium. This equilibrium is stable. If you have something like this, if you reach it exactly, the load is exactly the critical, it means it will buckle, right? It will buckle. This is kind of what neutral. This kind is neutral. It means it's like the ball on a flat surface. If you push it, it will go and reach another stable situation. It's on the verge to buckle. It's about to buckle. It's about to buckle. Okay? And this is, by the way, it's failure. It's failure. Neutral. We don't know how much it's going to move. But this is still. And the derivative of the concave, the function of the potential energy function is zero.
Plus.
Second derivative, zero. One of them is the potential energy function, the second derivative is negative, it means it's concave up. And one of them, this one is positive, it means it's concave down, and look what's happening. If you do this, if you exceed the critical buckling, it's kind of you are pushing a ball from a hill. Yani this سيارة أو عجل أو كرة عن جبل. You are pushing a car or a small ball from an edge like this. There's no way to stop it. This is called unstable. So if you exceed the load that you are pushing, exceed the critical buckling force, unstable. Unstable. How much is it going to go? It depends on the dimension of the member. Nobody knows, by the way. Nobody knows how much it goes.
Buckling goes to the best storage, yes, it goes.
Buckling?
No, we'll get buckling.
There's elastic buckling and there's plastic buckling. Yes. Euler equations are in the pure elastic here. And Euler, when he developed this equation, to verify his equation, to verify his equation, he wrote slender elements, long elements, with high slenderness ratio to stay in the elastic region. There is plastic, but even if there is some plastic deformation, when you remove the load, the elastic part goes back, and the elastic part goes back, will be permanent deformation, and you recover something, fracture issue. But there is plastic still not deforming. Here, this is an unstable situation. Formulated this equation, y squared e a over k l over r squared. is the x-axis, which is the length of the member. Here, remember the second, the double integration method? Remember this? The pin is? The pin. Engineering. before this was numbers. كان أرقام كان وعي متغير فيكس متغير. بعد هيك صاروا أشياء. صار this guy is a camera. That's buckling. That's coil. That's frame compatibility. That's deflection. That's rotation. This you know شو بتعرفوا يسموها هاي physical meanings of things. يعني هاي numbers وهاي رموز لها physical meaning عندنا بالإنجنييرز. هذا الخط is a beam. هذا الكيرف اللي هيك بيفورم شيب بلاستيك كيرف ثينجز بيكم فيزيكال ميزنج. واحد يقول لك شو الديريفيتيف؟ يعني شو الديريفيتيف؟ يعني ليش دلتا واي اوفر دلتا اكس سلوب تساوي دي واي اوفر دي اكس مثلا؟ ده كان سلوب ثابت. But if it's curved, the slope is changing. Then you talk about one small time piece in small differential element dx. طبعا تعريف السلوب رايز اور يعني اذا مشيت انا ما بطلعش بعد الضوء كثير. إذا بمشي قاعد بطلع لفوق there's a chain differential scaring. هاي how is the care is scaring rotation because it's rotation how it's scaring anyway. So this is the moment curvature. This is exactly how you drive this. Okay, this is how you drive. Now if you take a section here you want to find this is the only thing you do here يا جماعة هون بالعربي هون بدك بس العلاقة المومنت مع x العلاقة المومنت مع x من اللودينج بعدين هاي انتجريشن ماث بيور ماث افتر ذات. Once you get the moment function with respect to x is about integrating plus you integrate become y bar plus whatever here plus c1x then plus c1 then second one c1x plus c2 but then boundary conditions يعني how much y here how much y here zero no movement how much y here zero we say y equals 0 at x equals 0, y equals 0 at x equals l. C1 and C2, two unknowns, we find them. And differential equations, you know? Ordinary differential equations, uniform. Anyway, you will find that py equal m. Or so, if you take this one, this is not the right one. It's y positive this way, right? Remember when we took the sign to measure the moment, this is positive moment. So we have py minus plus m equals 0, you have minus m, sorry, p plus py minus m equals 0, so py equals m, right? So, ei squared, ei dy dy squared over dx squared equal minus py, minus py. You move it to the other side, it becomes plus py. So you have an equation with full y and with partial y, which is that's what they call differential equation. Yeah, the equation here y dy gets has a difference. It's called differential equation, second order differential equation. Right? The solution for this one, the one differential equation is the following. What's the shape of the buckling? It's like half sine wave. Half sine wave. Yeah, it's shape. Okay, from sine to sine. Remember? Solution y. Deflection shape. Remember, like this. Either one wave, or the second one shape is two. The third will be three. Right? So y is this function. A, a constant. يعني الأمضة تبعه is A. B. A sine, this is rho, this is not B, not the force, this is rho. X as a function of X, plus B cosine, this is rho, X. So this one is square root, B is the square root of B over EI. And if you go to the differential equation, you'll find the solution of this. The solution of this one will be Y equal A sine square root of this x plus b cosine square root of this squared. Okay, which is this. Again, b squared is b over a. So b here is what? Square. So in this one, the solution you take the square root of the factor of y, you put it before the x and the sine and cosine. So y equals 0 and x equals 0, right? 1 times B. So B is 0, so this is gamma. So the shape will be, we said it's half sine wave, we know it's half sine wave, this is the general shape. Boundary condition will tell you this. So it's A sine B, which is a constant, X, for rho. Okay? Again, this is rho, this is not B, the load. Okay? This is square root of the load over ER. So now, at X equal L, this is 0, right? So 0 equal A sine PL. 0 equal A sine PL. So, just equal 0. So either A equals 0 or sine PL equals 0. A equals 0, there is, means there's no loading. That's a trivial solution. No loading. No buckling. So either A equals 0 or sine PL equals 0. So if sine PL equals 0, this is your case here. When sine something equals 0, sine ishi equals 0, when it's 0 by 2 by 3 by n by 0 is a trivial, you don't care about it. So it's by 2 by 3 by something. So PL now, PL equal these thing here, right? So P equal by over L, 2 by over L, 3 by over L, n by over L. Right? So what's P now? Do the square. P square equal n square by square over n square. So P over EI, which is P square, equal n square by square over L. So P equal
EI times
n square by square EI over L square. Which is I got. This is the derivation of Euler. We should know it. Lesson to have what? Lesson. You should know it. And the most important one is when n equal 1, you get pi square ei over l square. So that's the first mode when the shape is half sine wave. And 2, by the way, n equal 2 is 2 waves. N equal 3, 3 waves. And you see, for the second one, the critical is 4 times. For the third, or when n equal 3, it's 9 times. By the way, this is the solution, right? Right?
Right.
So go back here. Go back here. A equal what? This. Right? Did we ever find A? Yeah. And so, did we calculate A?
No.
Did we, you know what's A? A is how much is? How much is goes? How much it goes? This is from the curve. This
is for the reflection.
It's how much it goes. It's this way, or this way, or this way, or this way. It's this amplitude of the curve. This is the, did we find it? No one ever found this. You don't need it. Why? Because if buckling will care, it's unstable. How much it will go, we cannot calculate. Maxim, hatta oil maxim. We did not calculate this one. But you go to the lab, this is how they did it. They go to the lab, they crush some specimens, and they see how much it buckled. And there's some trend. There's some trend that depends on how much it will go. 5 inch, 10 cm. It's, you cannot predict this one. So it's undetermined, it's indicated, or it was not calculated, and it's not a big deal. But no one ever calculated this. And this is the critical equation for Euler. And you can do this. See, be critical over. You rearrange this one, you write I equal R square A, right? I did it the other way. I equal R square, that is duration times A. Bring R down to become L over R square. Then divide by A, you will get pi square E. Why? This is F elastic. This is F elastic. Why you are saying this is F elastic? Because we are saying this is Euler. there is something in between. You can try yourself to calculate this. Then you 10 by 22, you take them down. 15 long, 10 connected column, this order. And you know how you do this? And you calculate that elastic. You calculate that elastic for this one, which is y squared e over kl over r squared. Calculate that elastic. You multiply, if f elastic is more than fy, wrong. If f elastic is less than fy, yes, you multiply it by the area, you get the strength. If f elastic, you calculate from this equation, is more than fy, it means Thank you.